I have a lot to do. I will demonstration.
And then I want to show my fiance what I learned today.
We should do the commercial next.
We're a very small Persian community.
So what are the different kinds?
Oh my god!
And this amazing award that welcome to Samira's show, and today we're gonna have a lot of fun. It's every Thursday morning at 11. We're gonna rerun it at 5 p.m. and 11 p.m. Here I have my permanent co-hosts Reatha Gray and Tamra Henry. Please say hello to the viewers, sweetheart.
Hi.
Hi. You've been going to so many awards. I know Emmy's coming up this Saturday. She's going. And Reatha Gray is nominated for the EOTM Award, right? So
yes.
Please tell us.
So what is EOTM? What is that?
I do know this. Entrepreneurs on the Move.
Okay. Wow.
So there are all kinds of awards for people who are in one business or another, entertainment, real estate, whatever, different phases.
Huh?
That are also entrepreneurs, and they're giving out awards on August 4th. It's really exciting. Our guest that's coming on later is also up for an award. I'm up for Outstanding Reality Star.
Oh, wow, that's amazing.
God, that's amazing.
I saw you on TV last week. I was just flipping through during the
Channel 4.
And you were on a daytime talk show.
Jeff Probst show last week.
Yes, Jeff Probst talking about being a cougar.
Oh,
are you serious?
Oh,
yeah.
Absolutely. Honey,
liking the young guys.
Watch out, I'm looking.
She's putting the message out there.
Which channel was it on?
That's on NBC, Jeff Probst show in the afternoon. Yeah.
It was so exciting just to have it on and just to see you there. I was like, I know.
Every time you flip the channel, we saw it on.
Yeah, I know. I was flipping channels. I found it too. Actually, we taped the show earlier, and that was an excerpt that I was there, but that's what they were talking about.
And you just came back from Comic-Con. You brought us some goodie bags, right?
Yeah, you can see all the people in the video. You can
and
see all the
crazy.
People.
It was like San Diego, right?
I love the big Comic-Con bags that you get.
140,000 people. This is the bag that they gave everybody that came.
Now that's
a purse. They had different things on it.
Oh, wow.
They had different shows that were being advertised on them. The Big Bang Theory was the most popular one. I couldn't get one. I was too late
to
get
one.
Oh,
and then on
I
the back, it's
that.
Got the Comic-Con logos.
Oh, how fun.
And inside it had the
so
books.
These were the gift bags, right?
No, they don't actually give you gifts, unfortunately. This came with your ticket. But I got my badge, my official badge to Comic-Con.
It was in San Diego, right?
In San
it's
Diego.
It's more like all kind of cartoon characters.
Cartoon, I went like 2 years
sci-fi.
Ago.
2 years ago. Mm-hmm. How fun. I want to go.
This was the events guy. Can you believe this? I mean, how many events they had.
Wow.
So you can't do everything. You can't see everything.
How fun.
And this is also a book that this has wonderful artwork in it.
Oh, wow.
It's, you know, they say suitable for framing. The stuff in here is suitable for framing. It really is.
Oh, wow.
Things
all
like
kinds
that
of
that
characters.
you can
How
actually
fun.
Just pull out and frame all kinds of comic book characters and stuff. Lots of fun.
Let's go see the video and come back.
Hi, I'm Reatha Gray, and I'm here at Comic-Con, and I am so excited. It's been a terrific weekend. But you know what? I'm even more excited because I'm going to go to the EOTM Awards on August 4th. That's right. I'm nominated for Outstanding Reality Star, and I'm also going to be a presenter. So I hope I get to see you there. Go to EOTM.com and get all the details. See you on August 4th. Yay! All those people that were there. It was like 140,000 people. It was crazy.
That's bigger than the convention center, right?
I know. It's
well,
huge.
People are everywhere. And then the other thing we got in our bag was a cape.
Oh, I love that.
So everyone got to be a superhero.
Oh, get up and show us.
So it just kind of hooks around you.
Perfect for you.
Hi, Jimmy.
So it hooks around. So everybody, if you didn't have your own costume, everybody showed up and you at least got a cape.
Oh, how
so
cute.
You could be a superhero.
The Batman, right?
Yes.
So there were lookalikes of Batmans and Supermans.
There were lookalikes for zombies and Wilfred.
What about
and
furry things?
You know, people did have their furry things with them.
Talking about Wilfred, the 2 years ago when we went to Comic-Con, we met Wilfred, and Jimmy Choo got his picture made with the Wilfred dogs. They had like 30 Wilfred dogs.
That's so cute.
And he got up in the middle of it, and he had fun. So.
I'm talking about Jimmy Choo. He has his own business card. He has
his own Facebook.
He just got new business cards.
New business cards and giving out. Can we also go to Tamara's photo rail and come back? And then we're going to go to the celebrity diets this summer.
Okay.
I need to diet, so you better help me.
Okay. I can help you lose weight.
And this weekend is a wedding show, right? So we're going to go to the wedding show.
Yeah, I love wedding shows. I have a couple of little frilly white dresses that I haven't worn yet.
You love wedding shows because you're engaged.
Right.
They make me sad. I'm not engaged.
Oh, my God. I forgot to wear my wedding ring today.
Well, you're not married yet.
I mean, my engagement ring.
When are you getting married? Soon,
I'm
going to
tell.
I think it's going to be spring 2014.
Well, wait a minute. Wow. Didn't you give him to me the last time we had a young guy?
I was going to trade on the last show.
Are you taking him back?
Did you change your mind?
You know, he's actually in France right now, so.
So neither of us have him.
Okay, let's go see it and come back.
Ese amor llega sin esta manera, no tiene la culpa. Caballo le dan sabana, porque muy despreciado, por eso no te perdono llorar. Ese amor llega sin esta manera, no tiene la culpa. Amor de compraventa, amor del pasado, ven, 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 ven. Perdón de Dios, tú eres mi vida.
Which is
Manners and More with
Manners
Millina.
And I'm really excited. I want to learn all about it. She's the actress and on The Young and the Restless of the CBS daytime drama in the General Hospital. You've been featured in many movies such as Talk Lab. We're going to show a trailer of that. And of course, you're also nominated for the EOTM Award that we're talking about.
Yeah,
looking forward to it. And she has her own talk show, which we're going on Monday, right?
Yes, you are. I'm so excited.
So me and Reatha are going to be on her talk show, and then Tamara also will join us. We'll do it again.
Okay,
definitely about us twice.
Absolutely.
And so tell me a little bit about you and how you got involved in the entertainment business.
Well, I actually went to school. First, I must apologize for my voice. I have a little bit of laryngitis.
Okay.
I don't normally sound like
a cross between Vincent Price Vincent Price and Tone Loc's Love Child is my joke. Mm-hmm. so I apologize for that. I started, let's see, as I was growing up, my path was to be an international corporate attorney with a concentration in the Spanish-speaking countries. So I went to the University of Virginia studying pre-law with a double major of Spanish and Foreign Affairs to that end. I was intended to take over my family's law firm. So that was my initial career path.
Mm-hmm. Smart.
And so, thank you. but it was a top, University of Virginia is a top 20 school. So it was crazy work. I mean, it was really, really hard because I still had to go to the parties and have a good time and hang out and go to the events. So I said, okay, I'm going to take a year off before I go to either Georgetown or Harvard for law school. Let me just, you know, take a moment. So during that moment, my mother kept telling me, you should enter a beauty pageant, enter this beauty pageant. Enter. I'm like, beauty queens, are they're just superficial. And, you know, I'm going to be an attorney and I'm not going to do that. Just do it, just do it. And I said, okay, Mom, fine, I'll do it. I won.
Wow.
And I won Miss Congeniality.
I'm here with three beauty queens. I want my crown. Where's my crown?
You're the silver fox.
Okay.
Tamara Henry.
We're going to get you in a pageant before this is over with.
Exactly.
There's a pageant for you. I'm going to find one for you.
There is, and I know of one because I actually used to be the executive director of a pageant.
Yeah.
So
we're going to get you a crown. Don't worry.
Absolutely.
So you won the beauty pageant. How did your life change after that?
First I had to rechange my thinking about that beauty queens don't have anything else except beauty going on. I said, well, I've won, so let me make a difference here. And so my platform was to stay in school. You have to get your education no matter what you want to do in life, whether you want to be an entertainer, whether you want to be a basketball player, what have you, get your education because you never know where life is going to take you. You need that. You have to have that. So get your education. Everyone must vote. It may seem like voting doesn't matter, but 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 will eventually get to what the desired number. You have to vote. Your voice matters. And third and most importantly is it is all right to say no. No one ever has a right to talk to you in a disrespectful manner, to touch you in a disrespectful manner, ever. And even if they're your family or your friends, if they are doing that and they're disrespecting you, they're not really your loved ones, they don't really have your best interest at heart, and you tell someone because it is not right. And so these are the three things that I was telling to these elementary and middle school and high school kids, and they were looking at me like, wow, this is great. And I'm thinking, I'm not saying anything new or different. Your parents should be telling you this, your teachers, your guidance counselors.
But they're
what
not.
What is making the difference?
They're not. They're the perpetrators.
Exactly. They're the perpetrators. But then I also realized that they were listening to me because I had this shiny thing on my head and a sash across my chest. Mm-hmm. I was in a position of authority that they respected.
Oh.
And I said, now where are the other role models? And at that point it came to me, maybe that's you.
Oh.
And it was just in a real quiet moment, maybe that's you. And I'm like, who's that?
That's so nice. Did you feel bad when you were at the beauty pageant?
Definitely. It does. It opens doors for you that normally wouldn't open.
It does.
It does.
It does.
Is it okay if we show her video? Okay. We're going to be ready in a few minutes. I want to show one of your trailer of your movie.
Okay. Well, I'll tell you how I got to that. Okay. Well, I actually, during the beauty pageant, the photographer said, send your pictures to New York. And I happen to have a boyfriend in New York, so I literally took the yellow pages and it kept with to the casting directors, managers, and agents, sent these pictures, and I started getting calls to be on New York Undercover and USA Live, and I got a call to be background in The Devil's Advocate. And I was like, but I was still going from Maryland to New York because remember, I went to school to be an attorney, not any of this acting stuff. So I'm just gonna check it out first. I'm not changing my entire life, just see. And then I said, okay, this is working. So then I landed my first major role on One Life to Live as Nora's legal assistant.
Oh, perfect.
Not a nurse, not Nora's legal assistant was my first major thing. And so then from there, I moved over to All My Children. While I was at All My Children, I made guest appearances on Guiding Light. And at that point, my agents in New York said, okay, what are you gonna do? You're gonna do Broadway and modeling, or you're gonna go to LA. I'm like, okay, I'll go to LA, I guess. But let me just see. So I took a year to see about L.A., and then I came out to L.A., landed a role as Talia on General Hospital, And now when all my children came out here, I went back to all my children, and a year ago, I landed a role on The Young and the Restless as Marjorie Curtis, and that is the award for which I'm being nominated, Outstanding Actress in a Daytime Series, for my role as Marjorie Curtis on The Young and the Restless at the EOTM Awards.
Wow.
And there's the story.
You've done them all. You've done almost all. Is there a soap opera that you haven't done?
Days, exactly.
Because that's my story. So you need to get on. I need to get on. Yeah.
We both need to be on.
We need to be on Days.
Exactly. That's the only one. Days and Bold and Beautiful.
Oh, okay. Wow. That's nice.
So that's how I ended up here.
How'd you guys meet?
Actually, our paths have been crossing a lot lately. We were at, what did we do first?
The NCNW. We were co-hosts at the National Council of Negro Women's Black Family Reunion.
Oh, wow.
A couple of weeks ago.
That's nice.
And then we went to a MMA fight together.
Mm-hmm. Oh, how fun.
The next day.
Do we look like we should be doing MMA?
Okay.
We're watching. We have lipstick. We have good lipstick.
We gotta go show the video of you at the Thug Love, the trailer of the movie of Thug Love. Yes, that was a really nice movie.
Oh, thank you. It's Jessica Sinclair's Thug Love, and it was an interesting film because my boyfriend in the movie, he's so nice in the movie.
He's good looking. He's sexy.
Mm. Oh, but I wasn't very. I was mad at him. He wasn't the most professional. Yet my husband in the movie, who was an absolute jerk.
Wait! How you work this? You got that going on.
And a husband and a boyfriend.
Okay,
we'll talk
about
it.
Let's go and watch it.
You know, he's fine. We're working some things out. I want to work it out too. I mean, I love my husband. Married for a reason.
Destin, I'm sorry I had to bring it to you this way. I'm done. I'm tired of being bored in a relationship.
My name is Troy. What's yours?
I'm Destin.
I don't care about your personal problems. Nobody here cares about your personal problems.
Let's get you to do one simple thing. One thing. Just come here for me. Not for you. This is about me. Come here, put on a suit, play nice for a couple of hours, and that's it. But God didn't say take abuse like this. Damn it, we deserve better.
You're doing some very risque behavior.
My grandmother will be able to watch this film and be proud of me. That is what I represent. Integrity, intelligence, and elegance. That's what I represent. And so everything that I do, you're able to hold your head up and smile.
Oh, that's so nice.
So which do you prefer, television or film?
You know, I really like the comfortability of television where you really get to know your co-stars and it's like a family atmosphere. You know, movies they're wonderful. You get to know people in a very short period of time, and you really get to know different personalities, but that's not always the real person. Mm-hmm. So I'm, you know, people who do what they do, whether they're an actress or talk show host or a teacher or a nurse, that doesn't matter. It's what's in here that's really important to me. And so the only way to really get to know people is to spend time around them. And that's
which
how
television you do.
Exactly. You can do that with television.
Which one makes more money, movie or TV?
Movie. Depending on the budget.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
And I can tell you because I'm actually executive producing a feature film coming up right now.
Oh, that's
so
nice.
It's good. I mean, it's starring Marla Gibbs, Della Reese. I have lots of heavy hitters, and it's a murder mystery suspense thriller, and I'm extremely honored and blessed to be able to do it. Howard Hewitt is doing the entire music soundtrack for it.
Oh, wow.
Angela Gibbs, Marla's daughter, is my director. So it's going to be phenomenal.
So you're a lawyer, actor, executive producer, talk show host. What, I mean, like, do you have any dreams left? What is, like, one of your big dreams you'd like to achieve?
I would like to be a mom. I'm not a mom yet. I'm not a wife just yet. I've been kind of busy with everything else.
Entertainment, you kept
saying. So you hear that out there, right? Melina and I, we're looking.
Too busy.
Well, actually.
Oh, they were looking.
Actually.
Oh.
And you'll see next week at the awards. Oh. I won't be going alone.
Oh.
Oh. All
right.
I have someone. But it's not out there yet officially.
But thanks, it will Reatha. Be next week.
Right.
Yeah. All right. I'll come back and tell you later.
We met on the red carpet actually a few months ago, and it's been kind of.
A red carpet romance.
Oh, woo. How sexy. That's nice.
Yeah. Okay. So I do want to do that. But I actually have my own jewelry line, too.
Oh, wow.
And I was noticing yours. It's so gorgeous. It is so gorgeous.
So you
I
only
love
wear six
jewelry
hats.
Line. That's beautiful.
Yes. Well, it's I don't make the jewelry. It's Crystal Coral Seas makes it. I liken it to Kim Kardashian doesn't sew her clothes. She picks it out and in the store. And so I pick out the ones that suit my, that represent me, and then that's what it is. So.
It's like a signature collection.
It is, Melina Gay's signature collection. That's
nice. She's all out there. She has like a line, she has the movie and TV. Wow.
So this is the Superwoman episode, right? Superwomen here. Comic Con Superwomen.
Melina Day's daytime Oprah. I love those. I used to watch Santa Barbara.
Oh, love Santa Barbara. Yeah. Oh,
I used to watch that. And it's addictive. A lot of people watch it.
Yeah.
Can we show her and her daytime Oprah and come back? Is it ready?
I love the daytime Oprah.
Mr. Baldwin, this is Marjorie Curtis, the employee who is cleaning up the rooms on this floor in the night in question.
Thank you, Detective. Miss Curtis, what a pleasure to meet you. I'm the district attorney. I would just like to ask you a few questions. I'm sure you've already heard about the tragic incident that took place here. The victim was seen exiting his room by that security camera right there. Shortly before his death, he walked up to your housekeeping cart and he discarded a newspaper into it. Do you remember that?
Sorry, I don't know anything.
Just a few more questions.
I should clock in. My shift is starting.
I cleared it with your supervisor. No worries.
Think again. Are you positive you didn't see a newspaper in the garbage bin of your cart? I'm sure you've heard rumors about the young man who was shot and who later fell to his death, but what you may not know is that the person accused of shooting him is the victim's own father. It is a tragic story, and I am desperately trying to make sure that justice is done for both of these people. If there is anything you can do to help me.
The paper was in the trash, which caught my eye because I always put them in the recycle bin.
Did you perhaps pick it up, maybe to put it with the recycling? Was there anything odd about when you handled it? Was there maybe something wrapped inside?
I found these.
That was amazing.
Thank you.
So what's the difference on your roles and the whole thing between General Hospital and
All My Children, One Life to Live, Guiding Light,
and then
Ring and Restless?
Yeah, Ring and Restless, because they're both pretty popular.
Well, the difference, General Hospital, I played the character of Talia, and I was the manager of the Metro Court Hotel.
Okay.
And now that I think about it, you're the first person that's asked me that. On Young and the Restless, I play Marjorie Curtis, who's a maid at the Genoa City Athletic Club.
Okay.
And so the manager, you know, she's kind of removed and talking with Carly and Sonny as they're the owners and, you know, kind of keeping her eyes peeled. Now, as Marjorie Curtis on The Young and the Restless, I mean, let me tell you, I'm lying to the DA, Michael. I'm stealing wallets and putting it in my purse and iPhones and then bringing it back to work the next day.
That's so exciting.
And then they're telling me, then they're reminding me, they're asking me, do you know anything about this? And I'm like, no, it wasn't me.
Did you ever want to finish law school?
You know, yes and no. This is the thing, because the structure of they were so intense, it just came naturally to me. So actually, I still get requested from my friends to do certain things. Like I can do a contract and look at a contract. I can help people with their trust, their wills, their bankruptcies, this and that. Now I don't handle. I have a law firm that handles all of my stuff, and I always send things through them just to make sure, because they always say the attorney who has himself for a client has a fool for a lawyer. Don't do it. So I can do all of my stuff. But I don't, and I suggest that. But people ask me to do things, and I'm like, I'm an actress. I'm a talk show host. I don't want to do that. But here, let me see what this is like. Okay, take this out.
Well, I'm good. She has her own show on Mondays about manners. So, Reatha, you please tell us what it is about.
Well, one of the things I was telling Millina, it gets so embarrassing. I'll go out to dinner with a young man. I like young men, but that's another story. Anyway, and they don't know which fork to use. They don't know where to start with the silverware.
Let's take her to the wedding show. She's ready.
I'm ready. I'll go.
or a young woman will ask me, you know, how do I set the table? What side does the fork go on? What's that? So it's something extremely needed. And Millina has a show every Monday that teaches manners. And today we're going to look at a table setting.
That's great. Pejman June, is it okay if you put the camera on the table? Because we're going to learn some manners.
And I brought my dinner gloves.
Oh, how fun. Have fun. Come sit here.
Okay.
I don't even know if that's appropriate. Dinner gloves.
Do
you have any extra pair? I want some.
I'm always grabbing props as I'm running out the door to come be on the show. And I heard about etiquette, so I was like,
oh, how nice.
Well, proper etiquette. The first thing that when you go into a restaurant, the proper way to enter the restaurant is, okay, first of all, you have the maitre d', and then he's leading you, he or she is leading you, and it's the woman and then the man. That is the proper order.
They have maitre d's at Mickey D's? No, we're talking about a real restaurant. Okay.
And then how you're supposed to sit is the person who is paying the bill. It sits where they are sitting a certain place. The guest is to the right of the person paying the bill.
Everybody sits on the other side.
And then you always want to make sure that you're sitting your guest facing a window, facing the restaurant. You never want to have them looking at the bathroom, looking at the kitchen. You never want to.
Why do you face them?
You face them looking out at the people, the ocean, at the trees,
at the
street,
at
the view. Have a scenic view, and you want to make sure that your guest has a good memory of the experience of the meal.
So that means that you have the right to say, no, I don't want that table. I would prefer to have that table over
there.
Yes,
absolutely.
How about if you're not paying for the table?
Well, if you're not, then you probably want to sit to the next, on the left side, because at least you still get a good view.
This is very interesting.
Yes, thank you. You know what? I've had the same challenges that you've had with people, like, taking their oh my gosh, I went on a date one time, it was so awful, that the gentleman, he literally ordered appetizers and he wanted to share it and do it in half. Okay, fine. Instead of putting half, he actually cut each of the things in half. In half! And then took his soup bowl and raised it to his lips and then finished his meal and took the plate and did like this. And then blew his nose at the table. I was horrified. And then said, when can we go out again? I was like,
never.
So it is just, it's a big challenge that people don't really know how to do the proper things. So first of all, you take your napkin.
Can we have the camera and the, please. Okay.
You have a napkin, and there are two types of napkins. Restaurants with cloth napkins, we love them the most. If it is a lunch, you fold a lunch napkin, which is smaller, you fold that all the way out and you place it on your lap. A dinner napkin is much bigger, so you only leave it halfway open. And you leave it here on your lap. You're not tucking it in here. You're not using like a cape over here. You're no, no, no. I've seen that happen. Oh my gosh. You just do it halfway and you lay it nice, neatly.
This is how
across.
To have a right table manner when you go out for dinner.
Exactly.
Any dinner, not even a date.
Any dinner, your even dinner at rice. Home. Just, you have to practice doing things the right way and then okay. you'll do them the right way in public.
And you right. know what's embarrassing?
Do you have more so we can practice too? Do we have any more?
Actually, I didn't get any more. I would just
have
one.
That's fine.
But you know what's really embarrassing? If you don't put your napkin on your lap and you're at a real restaurant, the maitre d' will snatch your napkin off your plate, yeah. and then he will put it on your lap.
Exactly.
And he will do it just like that to show that you don't know what you're doing.
Exactly.
So we all have napkins here. There are two napkins there.
I have a napkin.
Oh, yeah.
So let's practice.
So if it's lunch,
then you open all the way. If it's dinner.
If it's lunch, you open all the way. Okay.
Okay. So we're at dinner, and we lay the napkin.
It's half.
Yes, halfway. And then no one starts to eat until the host or hostess, picks up their fork. And then that's the signal for everyone to begin to eat.
Okay.
So now sometimes people pray, sometimes people talk, sometimes they hold hands. Whatever it is, whatever ritual that goes on prior to a meal, the host or hostess has that authority to make that statement. And all of the guests are supposed to adhere to that. Okay. Now, one major thing is nowadays people have cell phones going on. I know, who knew?
Mm-hmm.
And so a lot of times people will have their cell phones on the table. Rude. No cell phones on the table. Now, sometimes we in the business, we have to accept phone calls during, and if we're expected a phone call, the proper etiquette is to let your guests know in advance, I'm expecting a phone call. Please indulge me. I have to take this call, and you excuse yourself from the table. Don't sit there, Stevie Spielberg. No, you excuse yourself from the table and leave. Now, a good friend of mine suggested what he does is when he goes out to dinner, he makes everyone put their cell phone on the table, in the middle of the table. The first person who reaches for it has to pay the bill.
I like that one. That's a good one.
That's good.
We're going to take a break. Are we ready? We're going to show Tamara's Metro Motion, and we're going to bring in our Tamra Henry's other co-host
is here of our Emmy-nominated show. You guys are going to get to meet Joe McDonald. Yay!
Yeah.
He's young
and hot.
Oh,
you're gonna
really
love him.
Come on,
I
Joe,
love
come
it.
On.
Hey guys, I'm Joe McDonald.
And I'm Tamra Henry. Welcome to another fun episode of Metro Motion. Just the other day, I dropped by the California Science Center to check out the new Endeavor Shuttle exhibit.
Sounds a little bit out of this world.
Believe me, it was. Check this out. LA's newest star, NASA's Space Shuttle Endeavor, has finally arrived. Dubbed Mission 26, the shuttle made its final flight across the country, anchored on the back of a Boeing 747, then took a painstaking ride through the streets of LA before arriving at its new home, the California Science Center at Exposition Park. Governor Jerry Brown and LA Mayor Antonio Villaraigosa joined a star-studded lineup to dedicate the new exhibit and welcome the first guests, 500 Science Center school students.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, kids of all ages, welcome to the California Science Center, the Samuel Ocean Pavilion, and how about the Endeavor? Isn't she beautiful?
But Endeavor's real gift can't be expressed in dollars and cents. As I saw the excited crowds that gathered on our streets to see the shuttle.
For details.
The shuttle looked amazing, but where was my invite?
Maybe next time. But I do have to say, hopping on the Metro Expo line made it so easy.
Well then, we've got a train to catch.
Thanks everyone for watching. See you next time.
That was so much fun. Where did you go?
Hi, everybody.
Hey, Joe McDonald. Reynolds, where did you go? Where was that? That was so exciting.
We shoot that in Santa Monica TV, right over here around the corner. So mm-hmm.
You co-host a TV show together.
Yeah, we've been doing it for about 6 or 7 years. We do it like every 3 or 4 months.
How fun.
Yeah, it is a lot of fun. It's great content.
Every 3 or 4 months. And where do you guys go and film this?
Well, we do it at our studio in Santa Monica, but we also go out in the field and we talk about what's exciting with the happening rail lines and the buses, mm-hmm. and we are out there too. We're out all over LA County.
How fun! And yeah. we're gonna air some of your videos in our show. We would love to do that. Where was some of the best places you've been?
For me personally, well, we did a story about a bus that goes down Fairfax. So you're right near all the Ethiopian restaurants over there. So
how
I've actually
fun.
Gone to some of those on my own and had some Ethiopian food. So when I watch the show, it really shows me the different things that are happening.
And what
in
was
LA
that
County.
Video about?
That was Tamra and I hosting the show.
Yeah, yeah. What was it?
And that was the space shuttle Endeavour at the California Science Center.
Yes.
How fun!
Yeah.
Have you been there yet?
No. I like to go.
Yeah.
Tell me, I want to go too, right? Let's go.
Oh, I've been to the Science Center and saw the space shuttle.
I don't think I've been there.
Awesome.
Have you been there? Yeah. I don't think so. Where is
so
it?
So you, that's downtown in Exposition Park.
Yeah.
So you cover all types of transportation. It's not just the metro line.
We do, and what's happening with Metro, too. So they'll show the space shuttle Endeavour. They'll also talk about the tap cards that you use when you come on. When you go on, that's how you pay for your fare. So we just cover everything. The new construction, they're building a new rail line right over here, right in Santa mm-hmm. Monica, that's going to go to Santa Monica. It's called the Expo Line. So we talk about all that kind of stuff.
And we do fun stuff like green trivia. And it's also green, anything that's green and eco-friendly. And
well, you also have your own show called Tea.
Green Tea.
Green Tea.
Yeah. Green Tea with Tamra Henry.
And but what is that? What
it's kind of like a webisode, because our show is actually on television.
Yeah.
So my Green Tea is kind of like just a web show. It's like that kind of thing.
Just a web show.
It's just a web show.
It's a lot of work, too.
It is.
It's a lot of videos. It takes hours to do these things. Mm-hmm. People just see it for an hour. They're like, oh, my God, that's so much work.
Well, and you think the magic just happens, but it doesn't. It's a lot of planning that goes into a TV show. We're really excited about being nominated for the second time this year mm-hmm. for the local area Emmys.
I knew, and I saw your little poster. That was amazing.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, we were all over the buses.
Yeah, people
that was
were
fun.
Recognizing us. Yeah, it was good.
You were on the buses?
Mm-hmm. They put our poster up on the buses.
Oh, congratulations. Hi, I'm so lucky. I'm sitting next to this wonderful.
That's one of my dreams, is to be on a bus.
Yeah. I want to be on a billboard.
I want to be on a billboard, too.
In Beverly Hills.
We were on the inside
I'll
of the bus.
Anywhere.
Like, when you look up at the advertisements, mm-hmm. that's where we were. I mean, but we were still
but
on the bus,
you're
right?
The
that
bus.
Counts.
Yeah,
that
you're
count?
The bus.
Hey, they should put me, Reatha, and Tamara. We find a way to get
do
on
it.
The buses, too. Let's
exactly.
do it.
Yeah, let's do it.
Or we should just pay a fare and get on the bus. You can go take a ride.
Yeah, then you're good on the bus. You can see Tamra and I on the bus.
So we were good. We carpooled here today.
Oh, yeah. How fun. We're going to go and we're going to show the video. We're going to have a lot of fun today. Everybody's ready to dance.
I love the last segment.
Did you?
I learned a lot.
Did you?
Yeah.
So are you going to treat your date well?
Yeah, I think I was noticing.
Now you know if you want her to pay, you put her on the right.
You don't do that,
exactly.
Do you, Joe?
Well,
you don't
do that.
You sit down. No, wait, you sit down.
But, you know, it showed me that my parents did actually a pretty good job of showing me what to do.
That's
so,
good.
Yeah, it was good. Thanks, Melina.
That's why you turned out so good.
Oh, how cute.
Yeah, this is a great show. Fun energy.
Oh, thank you. Enjoying the show?
I am. I've been sitting over there cracking up.
Oh, that's great.
Especially this one here.
Oh.
She's amazing.
But you said you have a girlfriend, so I'm done.
Yeah, no.
Isn't he what you want? A young.
I'm not
He's
so
got
young.
A girlfriend.
Oh, okay.
Not so
we could do with that. So we're going to go to the $25 million house for the Michael's real estate, and then we're going to have Michael, our real estate agent and the producer of Samira's show, come in, and then we're going to go back and say to Melina, we're going to have the group of Funkalicious.
Yes.
They're wild and crazy. So we're going to have them dance, and we're going to go back to all of us and
booty?
Have some fun. Yeah.
They're fun.
So let's go watch the beautiful home
on.
For
Absolutely.
Sale.
Thank you.
the show.
Wow, which one of beautiful. These houses do you live in?
On all of them.
Oh, all of them.
All of them.
Isn't it beautiful?
It is. Beautiful houses.
So you can come for dinner at one of Michael's
mansions.
Not exactly mine, but as you can see, these homes, this particular home is a beautiful mansion with all the amenities that you need for a house, and almost like a little castle. It's got theaters, it's got several.
It's nicer than a castle.
It is, and the workmanship on it was incredible. It's all French style decorations and walls and everything. It's beautiful. And of course, you know, with the price tag of $25 million, you have to have the right buyer for it.
Or maybe after you win your couple of awards, you can afford it, Reatha.
They don't pay you for awards, so no.
Well, you can find a rich boyfriend who can buy.
Hey, some people want you to buy
like
the awards.
I like it.
A rich girlfriend, yeah.
No, a rich girlfriend. Well, maybe after your wedding.
Yeah, I'm gonna need a big new house for newlyweds. Is one of those perfect for newlyweds?
Of course, of course. I'm going to send this to your fiancé.
Right.
I'm going to send this to your fiancé with the contract. Just tell him to sign the
bond. That was a beautiful house. Was $57 million. That was a beautiful house too.
That one was incredible. It had 20 acres of land in Beverly Hills. I mean, something you
20 take. Acres in Beverly Hills?
Can you imagine that?
Didn't know.
Oh, my goodness.
I didn't know such a land existed.
What is the most valuable thing when you buy a house? What do you look for? The square footage of the house, the location?
The bathroom.
And the kitchen.
A lot of people look at the kitchen, right? The kitchen's very important.
The bathroom and the kitchen.
What's valuable?
Well, usually the first thing is the land, where it's located. If a piece of land is located in downtown Los Angeles, it's worth something for commercial. But if it's for living, it's not. Beverly Hills, you know, Bel Air, Santa Monica, Malibu, the pieces of land are important. Of course, then it's the structure of the building, how large it is, what facilities it has. And then, of course, you know, the decorations, the furniture, and of course, as a lady, the kitchen. And bathrooms and the other.
What do you think is more important, the kitchen or the bathroom? I think the
bathroom.
Kitchen. You think so?
Because the kitchen won't do anything but make you fat.
That's true.
That's one way of looking at it.
The kitchen is closed.
And I say kitchen, but ask me the last time I cooked.
Yeah, I was going to say something.
You know I don't cook.
But you know, at least
and when
you
go into the bathroom, you want to look good in the bathroom.
Like it.
So, in the bubble bath. So.
You take a lot of bubble bath?
Yes.
Oh, no, you have to have a jacuzzi.
Yeah, because it makes the bubbles. The bubbles come up to here.
Steam I like shower. The mirror around it. That
yeah,
would look
everything
nice.
Mirrored.
They spend more money in a kitchen, almost as large as a like
you know,
a
it's
house,
a fashion to have a nice kitchen because nowadays a lot of people hang out in their kitchens.
That's why I like the kitchen. I like hanging out in the kitchen. I don't like cooking there.
I guess you really can't have your party in the bathroom, right?
Yeah.
And you'll have
no, if you have a hot tub, you can, really.
Okay.
It depends what kind of party you want to have.
Exactly.
You know, I've been invited to all kinds of red carpet. At the end, they might have one in the nice one of those.
You're talking
you have
about
to launch the show.
We can start a new trend, bubble bath parties.
Oh, yeah. That's
you're talking
nice
about
one.
Bathroom size. There was one of my clients had
that's
a house.
A
she had a living room in her bedroom.
Mm-hmm.
So
oh,
you could have
nice.
A sitting area the size of where we are right
oh
now.
My.
You could almost just the living room mm-hmm. inside her bedroom. Imagine how large it was.
I've seen houses like that.
It was like 20,000 square feet building for the house.
Well, that's wonderful. We're going to party now. We're going to, and we can have Millina set the table and
teach
invite
us
some
to,
of the royalties.
Behave.
Talking about royalty, you were talking about the prince just had a baby. But we didn't have the Prince Henry.
Yeah, Prince
his
George.
His name is George.
Yes, Prince George.
Congratulations, right?
Exactly. Congratulations.
I don't know. We didn't make the video, but we'll show it next week maybe. And
you have
it
a
was
picture
so
of the
cute.
Prince?
I
didn't
make the video. Oh. I don't think fix it. But yeah, it was so much press outside the hospital.
Mm-hmm.
And I think they changed the hospital. It was crazy.
It was.
So, yeah. But
and
good.
And I heard that they didn't put the baby in the car seat right.
Oh.
And people are criticizing them. It's like it's their new baby. They didn't know. They'll learn.
But she looked good coming out of the hospital, right?
Mm-hmm. She did.
And she was back there with the baby.
The Kardashian just had a baby girl, too.
Maybe it was her double.
The Kim Kardashian just had a baby girl.
North.
North.
And it got a lot more press than the royal baby, didn't it?
How come?
I saw some statistics that said the Kardashian baby was way more ratings.
Because they charged to show the baby.
Okay. Because Kanye was beating up photographers, that's what.
But I didn't see her on a video, though. I don't think they put her on any talk show.
No, they haven't shown pictures of her yet.
I think the mom wanted to or something. But they
want to charge millions of dollars. I'm not mad at them. If I had a baby, they'd pay me $1 million to see it. I'd charge it.
Why not?
They got a lot of rent to pay.
Why give
then
it
you
to
can
it?
Have a bathroom and a kitchen and whatever.
That would rebuild everything.
Why do it for you, right? So, actually, we just went to an amazing charity, which we're going to have our guest back. It was an amazing charity. It was at the Calabasas Mercedes-Benz. It was about a week ago. And this was by Natalie Sarkeesian, amazing family. The girl, she got leukemia at the age of 17, and she passed away. So, for 6 years, the family made charity on her name and a fashion. She wanted to be a fashion designer. So after she passed away, they found 22 designs for her. And so the mom decided every year to make a dress for her. And it was amazing. Very, very classy. Very top fashion show. Very nice people. And the mom did it. She had a lot of support, a lot of great sponsors. And we were invited to go to the event. So we're gonna show how it was. It was really fun. I liked the energy and how everyone supported her from everywhere, from the city, from everyone. They gave her awards, and she wants to make a difference. She has some problems that we're gonna talk about with insurance for the daughter. Let's go see the charity event and come back.
It's important to acknowledge the past, which comes with some sadness. So it's been almost 6 years since Natalie Sarkeesian's death. And as you can imagine, every day and every week and every month and every year that goes by, it doesn't really get easier for her family. There are always those feelings of emptiness.
Hey. Welcome to Samira's Show. We have here with us a group called Funkalicious. Funkalicious is the future of funk music. They take you back into fun times of 70s and 80s. And they're going to do a dance funk for us. What kind of dance you guys are going to do right now?
We're going to do Sexy Body.
Sexy Body?
Yeah, Sexy Body. Yes.
Is it too wild?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. We keep it not too wild on national TV. I'm so excited, and I saw all your crazy fun things. I love your little bling bling outfits. I love tigery stuff. So this is the disco style of the 70s and the 80s. So let's have fun. You do one song, and then we will all join you and do some dances on the second song. You sing and you dance.
Yes.
And you actually have more than five people in your group.
Yeah, it's actually.
So next time you come back with all of you.
Yeah, it's actually 10 okay. of us.
All right, so excited. Is the music on? Bye, good luck. So they're going to do a live performance for you guys.
Uh-oh.
I like it. I like I love your outfits. Welcome to Samira's show. Is the microphones on? Can we talk? Yes? Okay, good. So.
We're here.
you guys are great.
Thank you.
First, Funkalicious. Mm-hmm. Okay. You guys are a theme of the 70s and the 80s.
Yes.
There's 10 of you.
Yes.
Okay.
And we're a live band.
Yeah.
We're live band. Yeah, I know.
Just to mention everything.
Well, please introduce yourself.
I'm Freddie Sweet Eyes.
Can everybody come in? Because it's not showing. Would you like to come in too?
Yeah, come on. Yes.
Joe, you can come in too.
Yeah.
Just go to the back so we can talk. Okay, so please introduce yourself. Louder, because the microphone's a little bit far because you guys were dancing. Okay.
I'm Freddie Sweet Imes. I am the founder of the band Funkalicious.
Yeah, we talked.
And we're the new generation of funk music.
Okay, and how did you form this group?
Well, about 10 years ago, almost 10 years ago, I got a voice. A voice said, you need to start a funk band, right? Or you're not going to make it. Because we all work with a lot of major recording artists. And I decided that it was time to step away from being in the background, singing background with a lot of major people for years. And I decided to venture off and start my own band.
Okay.
And this is it. You have Georgie Porgy. And then we have Chocolate Q.
Is this like a special outfit you guys are wearing?
Yes.
Is it represents?
Yeah, what we do. I am actually a chef.
You are. Yes. Oh, you have to cook for us next time, then.
Put everybody in the hospital.
So you are actually chef too,
yes.
And then you also do this band.
Yes.
Oh wow.
I play keyboards the same lead and background vocals.
We are all mostly friends, and
that's
we work
nice.
Together.
Oh, fun.
So who else do you have?
So
you have that on guitar, the Chocolate Q.
Chocolate Q.
I love your outfit. My God, I love this. Please come in. Can you show everybody your guitar? Turn this around. I love your style.
Oh, sorry.
Hey, we're all tigering. We match.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, that's great. That's great. What do you think, Tamra and Reatha?
I like chocolate.
No chocolate can be very bad for you.
Yes, my name is Quincy. I'm Mr. Q. Actually, I'm a skater of Funkalicious. You know, I usually have my roller skates on, but hey.
We were not supposed to put rollerblades, so sorry.
Yeah,
okay.
It's okay. It's okay, because we got to do
so
it.
So you do the rollerblades?
Yes,
there.
Yes, I'm the roller skate. Yes.
How fun. And
yes.
What are you supposed to be?
Well, I got my little outfit on, two-piece, you know, with the tiger, with the cheetah. You know, I love cheetah, you know,
well,
I have
I
a great
it,
time
like
with
it,
the band.
Mm-hmm. That's funny that I wore this today. I mean, it was an accident, but it matches everybody.
So you're like the Hugh Hefner of the group.
No, that's him right here.
I'm more of like a...
This is a live band, so you actually play, right?
Yes.
Okay. It's not on, is it?
No.
Okay, so do you want to introduce yourself?
I'm the Funk Professor.
The Funk
this
professor?
This is our big brother, yeah.
Oh, like a professor of funk.
That's right.
I'm the Funk Professor. I'm the bass man.
Oh, okay, wow.
I play you bass, can hear I it in the voice, bass. Can you? Yes.
So how do you, like what do you get? Like, do you do live bands? Do you guys do movies? How do you?
Well, we've done a lot of things. We also were the winners of the GOD Award, the Performers of the Year.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
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 We have the whole GOD Award. Hey, we can promote the show on the GOD Award. I should get an award, too. Okay.
Yeah, and also, I'm a Grammy Award winning songwriter. I used to write jingles for commercials years ago.
Oh, wow.
And I won in February, I won the Humanitarian Award from the President of the United States, Obama.
Wow. You got the Humanitarian Award from the President. He got the Humanitarian Award from the President of Obama. Okay, go on.
Yeah, and we try to give back to the community from which we grew up. We grew up in South Central Los Angeles, and I went to the Young Saints Performing Arts Academy, And me and Jerry, actually, we met when I was in high school. And we've been together, because I play guitar, too, and he played guitar. So we've been playing together since we've been teenagers. Okay. And like I said, everybody else in the band, we've been knowing for a long time, and our friends. And it was like God was taking the pieces and putting the pieces with us. And it's all about fun, having a good time.
It looks like fun. Yeah. I'm all excited. I mean, you guys are so funky. I love your shoes, too. I love this. So bling, bling. So can we party with you? Can
sure.
we do one more song?
Yeah. Okay, yeah. but we got to go. Okay, the song we were going to do, you got to go to the number three song.
That's number three, can we skip?
Say goodbye and then that's
and then also, I would like to say thank you, Rita. Is there anything you would like to ask them?
No, I'm ready to party.
So Rita Gray, congratulations on your upcoming award.
Thank you.
Tamra, where did you go? And Millina, thank you for coming on Samira's show. If anybody wants to find you, Reatha is always here, but where would they find you?
Well, you can follow me on @MillinaGay on Twitter. You can follow my show, Manners and More with Millina.
And I will be on her show. How will people find you at the show on Monday?
It's rmconair.com.
rmconair.com. We're going to be on Millina's show, me and Reatha, on Monday.
Yes.
So looking forward to that. And... what
yes,
is this?
Thank you what's for having okay, us.
So I forgot to show my toys. I'm a big toy girl. I like puppets. And my mom said that because I'm wearing a yellow dress to the Emmys, right? She goes, well, you're going to look like Big Bird. And I said, well, who does that make? Joe.
Ernie Amber.
Go Metro. Go Metro.
Go Metro. We're going to have you back again. You're
thank
cute.
You. It's fun.
Okay, so are we ready to party?
Let's do it.
Just stay within this so we can all dance, right?
Okay.
Okay, so number three. You want to come in too? No. Okay, thank you, Michael Makabeh, our real estate investor. You saw guys saw their home. And John Campton, who's here to do the thing. And Jimmy Chu. Of course, there's always room for Jimmy.
Come on, Jimmy.
To come and dance. Come on, Jimmy. Okay, ready? Put the music on. So we're going to do a little dance with you guys. And where will people find you guys?
Okay, go to Reverb Nation, Funkalicious. That's our website.
Funkalicious. Okay. Are you guys ready? Let's party.
With me.
weekends. I love, thank you, Dr. Mazzari, DDR TV, everybody, the crew. And we're going to go watch Samira's show for Samira Gem Creation Jewelry. Thank you for wearing my jewelry. We're going to end it with that. Thank you for coming to the show. It was fun. Thank you. So let's go watch the jewelry rail, and we're going to close the show. Love you guys. That was fun.